Well, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Master Paul coming to you live. I am in Honolulu at this time, out and about. We just finished the call with Dr. and Master Shah, and he was on the call with Adam Markell for this weekend's financial workshop. He even talked a little bit about the soul marketing, and I thought that was very fun to hear. Because I know that Dr. and Master Shah uses soul marketing every day. He teaches all of his students and divine channels to use it every day. And it's going to be the focus of what we'll be doing here today, is also focusing on soul marketing. It looks like the connection is much stronger here today. That's good. Yesterday it was hiccuping a lot in and out. I'm waiting for people to come in. It's just starting to connect right now, so that's good. And more people will come in because they just got off the phone call with Dr. and Master Shah. So it'll be a couple of minutes before I go into the actual communication about what we'll be talking about here today. So I'm very, very happy about today's subject. Soul marketing is something that is near and dear to my heart. I have been using it myself quite a bit. And I think one of the things that is most important to understand about soul marketing is the nature of soul and why it's so relevant. Soul is literally the source, the center of every aspect of Dr. and Master Shah's teaching. And it is truly, when you take the time to understand the nature of soul, and that everyone and everything has a soul, we can certainly move forward substantially faster in every aspect of our life. So I'll take a moment and acknowledge Archana, welcome. Anne-Marie, welcome. Kristen Strachan, welcome. To see all of you. So I'm guessing most of you were on the call with Dr. Master Shah and Adam Markell. I just came to it after that. I have no idea how many people will show up today since I started about 20 minutes late. I did, you know, post a notice, but whoever shows up, and whoever watches the video will be blessed. I am outside, as you can tell. There's wind sounds. There's a helicopter overhead. You might hear a siren go by. I'm actually at the Botanical Gardens here in Honolulu. When I decide to do something outside, I never know exactly where it's going to be. It just happens to be where I am near that has a good cell phone signal and tends to work out. So today, hopefully, this was good. So Dr. and Master Shah, he teaches the power and the nature of soul. Welcome, Suki. I will be answer one of your questions when we get ready to do that part, so hang in there. And what I mean by that, you know, the subject today is soul marketing. However, soul marketing has to have a base. It has to have a foundation. And when I first started connecting to the teachings of Dr. and Master Shah, which was in 2008, he talked about soul conferencing. And soul conferencing is the predecessor to soul marketing. When we comprehend the value of soul conferencing and we start employing that in every area of our life, we can have a huge result and a huge benefit when it comes to soul marketing. One of the reasons why is because we will actually practice in advance of the soul marketing. We become a lot more comfortable. So welcome Yvonne, welcome Cynthia Marie, welcome Crystal, welcome Daraj. So what is soul conferencing and why is it the predecessor to soul marketing? Soul conferencing is literally connecting from soul to soul. Now, for me, that was such a huge enlightening aha moment. And almost immediately after, I went home and I read the books and I started to apply soul communication. Master Shah, he taught that everyone and everything has a soul. And we hear it, but do we actually do anything with it? You have heard me do soul communication with inanimate objects, inanimate things, thoughts, and possibilities. The soul of, for example, the one in charge of divine healing hands. These are things you can't hear or see. And so, thank you for sharing, Yvonne. And so, when we start to truly, truly bring into our life the knowingness, the awareness that everything has a soul. And we move from the knowingness and the awareness. I'm going to clear blockages on my phone just a second. Divine order, clear the blockages on the phone, put up a light wall protection so that there is no skipping transmission. So one of the keys of what makes soul marketing work better is applying soul to every aspect of our life. It starts at home. It starts at work. Does your boss have a soul? Does the relationship between you and your boss have a soul? Yes. Do your children have souls? Does the relationship between you and your children have a soul? Yes. When you get in an argument with your spouse, is it better to go try to talk to your spouse, or is it better to talk to the relationship and the soul of your spouse? Well, that depends. How open is your spouse to talking at that time? Is there a pattern by which a major argument happens and then it takes 2 to 3 days to recover? If that's the pattern, why in the world would you try to do anything other than communicating at the level of soul? And so one of the things that happened for me when I first started understanding that everything has a soul, as I started to confidently and consciously communicate soul to soul with everything that has a soul whenever the opportunity showed itself. So if I had a blockage at work, if I had a blockage with finances, if I had a blockage in relationship, didn't matter what it was, I looked for where is the soul in this blockage area and how do I connect to that? That was my focus. And what that allowed me to do was feel very comfortable. The reason it helped me to feel comfortable that it worked was because I saw the results. So that's my first teaching to you, is recognize that there is the greatest opportunity of soul conferencing. Soul conferencing incorporates some of the exact same things that was mentioned yesterday by by the soul that came to speak, the soul of soul marketing. First thing that soul said was, start with love, then forgiveness. So welcome, Nicole. Welcome, RD. And soul conferencing works the same way. So, you know, we have those people, objects, things, conditions in our current life that we want to see transformed. And the best way to accomplish that is not directly. Rarely is it directly. Almost always the best way to accomplish it, especially if it's a blockage, is indirectly at the level of soul. Because you have to remember, when I'm offering healing, and a person has no clue what I'm doing, and they want to understand. One of the ways I explain to them, which applies to this here, which is soul conferencing, is that we are soul first. We are, you know, the mind, the energy, the body later. So everything that's already happened up here literally has a mirror image reflection down here on the physical plane. So if you have pain in the knee, then the blockage is in the knee up here at the soul level. And I'm describing up and down. I'm describing the soul up here and the physical body down here. And what it does for that person when I'm describing it is it helps them to comprehend that their soul does carry forth lifetime to lifetime, and that it does carry karma lifetime to lifetime. And that that if they comprehend that karma sits at the soul level, that when you can remove it up here, that the reflection changes down here, then they get that big aha moment that allows them to accept and receive the healing. This same comprehension is when you're dealing with things at soul conferencing level. You are dealing with things at the level of soul. You call forth the soul of the relationship, for example. Now, when you're dealing with the souls of relationships, the soul of a relationship is it has many, many lifetimes. It has a history. And so if we try to go directly to that person, when we know that that direct conversation has not worked in the past, what possibly thinks that any great words of wisdom are going to change the communication, that relationship, if it hasn't worked already? Better to deal with it at the level of soul, hence soul conferencing. Call forth their soul. Ask for forgiveness. Do deep and authentic forgiveness. Send love to that soul. That love and that forgiveness transforms the relationship karma that runs from all of your lifetimes, not just this one. Trust me when I say, if you're having consistent blockages in a relationship, if you're having consistent blockages in finances, if you're having consistent blockages in anything, there is a history associated with it. And that history has a relationship. Everything has a soul. Relationships have a soul. Finances have a soul. Your businesses have a soul. Today is on the subject of soul marketing. When I talk about soul conferencing as a predecessor to soul marketing, it's based on this comprehension, this understanding that everything does have a soul. And so yesterday when I was doing the flow on the nature of, welcome Kristen, great to see you. Welcome Allison, great to see you. When I'm talking about the nature of soul in relationship to marketing, it's very key. One of the things that came out when I was doing the flow yesterday was that it must be win-win. This is so relevant. Do you think God created us so that we could command another? Highly unlikely. We are all individuals finding our way back home, and the only way possible is through supporting each other on that way back home. So if we're doing soul marketing, it cannot be for our success. It has to be for all the success of all involved. And it's the same thing for any soul conference. You might be in a very self-righteous place with against that boss or against that competing business that is striving very hard to harm you, or any other something happening in your life. We must come at it from a deeper and higher, more aligned perspective. And so one of the things that was being shared through this flow from the soul of soul marketing is that do everything from a perspective of win-win. So for example, and I'll go through the processes that we repeated yesterday because today's cell phone connection, thank God, is a lot better. And hopefully it won't skip a lot, whereas it did yesterday. I imagine some things were lost in the translation yesterday. So in doing the soul marketing, what's the first step? The first step is surrounding ourselves with as many holy beings as we can, because their purpose in life is to serve. The reason they're a holy being is because they have served. That's why they have a higher soul standing, a higher status, and a desire to serve. So we want to ask them to be present to assist us in whatever way they feel is appropriate. That's step one. They're the soul of Jesus, Mother Mary, Buddha, Kuan Yin, God, Tao, Source. Call them all forth. Ask them to come and always ask as appropriate for their blessings. That's step number one. Step number two, turn on all your transmissions and treasures. Whether you're a student of Master Shah or not, you have received transmissions and treasures from the Divine. They are in your body and they are there to serve you. So turn them on. They're all my downloads, treasures, transmissions. Please turn on. I love you, honor you, and appreciate you. As appropriate, could you please bless this soul conference, soul communication, and soul marketing? So step number one, call forth all the holy beings. Step number two, turn on all your downloads and treasures. Now, as I mentioned yesterday, this is another important step. Dr. and Master Shah has successfully navigated a very difficult world, bringing the concept of soul over matter into this world, bringing the concept of heal the soul first and the mind and body will follow. Whenever you're a maverick, whenever you bring these kinds of concepts, you're going to get resistance from mainstream. And yet he has managed to navigate through all that with love, with forgiveness, with compassion, because he doesn't attach and he gives them love even if something negative is said. And one of the things that is relevant to help support that is that he has asked Heaven's teams to clear the blockages. What does that mean? That means Heaven has generals and soldiers, teams in Heaven that can assist to remove the blockages. He has given any of the students that are supportive of love and peace and harmony agreement to ask those teams in Heaven to come. They're called Heaven's marketing team. You can ask them to come if your mission is to assist bringing forth love, peace, and harmony. They will come if they have the time and if they feel your heart. And they will do whatever clearing is appropriate that they are allowed to do. And so you call them forth as well. The next thing that the flow said to do is said to ask for forgiveness. Now that's after this. He said, start with love. So we call forth all the holy beings. We turn on all of our treasures. We ask the marketing team as appropriate, Heaven's marketing team, to come. That includes generals and soldiers who come and clear blockages. And then we start to use love. The highest frequency that we have available to us is the source soul song of love, peace, and harmony. I'm not going to go into the power of that right now. Most of you know. If you don't, do yourself a favor and learn about it. It will change your life. So play or sing love, peace, and harmony for a couple of minutes. Ask all the souls that you have invited to join you, and then sing it. Give me a minute. I got to drink some water. So I got a little ahead of myself. We don't want to chant love, peace, and harmony yet until we invite all the souls in. So now we're going to ask for all the souls that we are doing marketing to in. Now, it's key that you don't invite souls that don't need to be there, okay? If you speak French, why would you invite souls that don't speak French? If that's your only language you can communicate in and write in, all the other souls aren't going to receive value out of your marketing materials that they find you through. The purpose of soul marketing is that when people hear your message through the Soul Conference, when people see your flyers, your website, your materials, and everything that you've put out there, they instantly recognize it. They instantly feel comfortable and trusting. Why? Because you spoke with their souls way in advance of them ever seeing your materials. That's the purpose and intention of soul marketing. So how would you accomplish this? You would call forth the most appropriate souls. If you were, for example, doing a love, peace, harmony chanting group in your area to serve humanity, do the souls of all of those in the island of Oahu, could you please come to the Soul Conference? If you were able to communicate on telephone or a live stream like this, then call everybody in the English-speaking world. That's okay too, because you never know who your audience is going to be. So it depends on your limitations, your ability to communicate as to who you would call. Okay? So call forth those souls as appropriate. If you were, for example, you had a specific business like plumbing, okay? A specific business like marketing for websites, then you would call forth, dear all souls in the English-speaking world that are interested in marketing their websites and are currently or in the future will be looking for an excellent website marketer. Please come to the Soul Conference. So you see how this works? You would ask accordingly. That's correct, Kristen. We are calling them in energetically. From the soul world's perspective, every soul is not limited by time or space. So when we call them, they will come, assuming they're not busy. And then the next day, if we called again, some other ones might come that were busy before. So it is a form of trusting. Unless your third eye is wide open, you'll see them if your third eye is wide open. But it is a form of energetically calling them. That's correct. So then we call forth these souls. Now, this is where the next important steps come in. First one, we must connect heart to heart, soul to soul with all of those souls that we've called in. And we need to instantly transform any blockages that are present. We do that with love. And so we sing love, peace, and harmony, and we connect with them. We say, dear all of the souls that have come forth to this soul conference, soul communication, soul marketing, I love you. Please sing love, peace, and harmony with me. Please turn on this soul song of love, peace, and harmony. Join with me. Also, ask all souls in all universes. Kristen, you might not know this, might be foreign to you. All souls in all universes have this song transmitted to it. So you ask all souls in all universes to chant with you. And then you chant. A couple of minutes, you'll know when it feels right because you'll feel calm, you'll feel relaxed, and you'll feel centered. So chant until you're calm, relaxed, and centered. Next step, very, very important. Forgiveness practice. You have no idea if you have created karma or your ancestors have created karma with all of these souls that you're trying to attract to your business. You have no idea. It very well could have, there's a lot of people that are suffering financially right now, and they are very intelligent. They have exceptional business prowess. They have plenty of skill. They have done A, B, C, D, E, and F correctly. they can't rub two nickels together, can't seem to get people coming to them. Very simple solution, business karma. They need to ask for forgiveness. They need to receive business karma cleansing. If it's ever made available to them, they need to get it. They need to check into Dr. Master Shah's calligraphies, do whatever you can to clear that karma, because that's really the bottom line of why it's not working. And so you ask for forgiveness. Dear all the souls, be authentic. Dear all the souls, in this, in every lifetime, if I or my ancestors have cheated you, lied to you, caused you to suffer financially in business or in any other way, if we have been greedy, corrupt, if we have caused you to lose your business and therefore lose your health, your relationships, your home, your livelihood, if we have done anything in any way, in any time, I truly, from the bottom of my heart, apologize. Be authentic. Be sincere. Think about the different ways people can be harmed. You might have had an ancestor that ran a bank, took people's land when they couldn't pay, and then the family was out on the street. Maybe one of the kids died of some disease, and the parents got to witness their child die because one of your ancestors was not very nice and could have given him a little bit longer to pay the bills. You never know what the karma is, so you be very authentic in asking for that forgiveness. What this does is it opens the hearts of all those souls that have come to listen to you. Now, one of the other things that came through the flow, I was actually very surprised when I received this information. And the flow means a message from the soul that I asked to communicate with. In this case, it was the soul of soul marketing. The soul of soul marketing came. And I did write down the flow, by the way. If you send me a message through my email or text message, I will email you the flow. But one of the things it said was that when you call forth souls, there are many different ones that come. Some that come are curious. They just want to know what it's all about. What are you doing? Why are you calling these souls? Some that come are ones that have been hurt before. They come to block you. They come to see what you're trying to do to generate success, because they don't want you to have that success. So when you call forth these souls, many of them come, and some of them are unexpected, which is another good reason why you want to ask for forgiveness. So that is the next step. Be authentic. Now you have the highest, most open heart possible to deliver your message. Now it's taken me, 20, 25 minutes to deliver this message to you. When you actually do the soul marketing, honestly, maybe 5 minutes to prepare, maybe a few more minutes to sing and do love, peace, harmony, forgiveness, and then you do the soul conferencing. So what is the core of the soul conferencing? You have to remember, how are the people going to find you? Aside from the mechanical physical world reality, which is Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, newspaper ads, paper ads, word of mouth, all forms of marketing, media, and advertising, that's the real physical world reality. They also come through unexpected forms, and I find that to be actually more true. I have consistently found that when I do soul marketing, when I am persistent and consistent with it, they come out of the blue. I mean, it's just very foreign. The last place I would have expected them to come from is where they come from. And that's, I think heaven does that purposefully to let us know that heaven's in charge, and that as long as we are supporting humanity, they'll support us. I'm confident that heaven delivers that message in that way. So you'd be surprised. But why do we do soul marketing through this process? It is to release the blockages. And then what do we do when we actually talk to those souls? What we do is we say, hello, I love you. I'm inviting you to pay attention to the services that I offer, to the event that I'm doing. Whatever it is you're talking about, to my business of plumbing and electricity, whatever it is, I'm inviting you to pay attention to this. Then you state specifically all the different ways in which they can find you. Currently, I have a magazine ad. I have my Facebook. I have my YouTube channel. I have events posted on Facebook. And so I talk about those events. If I have a specific event, I have the flyer in my hand. Please come to my event at the Waikiki Community Center. It's for the next 6 Thursday, starting August 11th. It's called the Tao of Reversing Pain and Aging, and so forth. And then I would actually read everything. Now, keep in mind, I'm by myself in my room, okay? I don't want people thinking I'm crazy, but at the same time, I am very connected to those souls. I don't really care what other people are thinking outside of me. I'm present. And I'm telling them what they are going to see. And I will say to those souls, so when you see the flyers that I have placed at these stores around town and at the community center, when you see my picture of my face, when you see the words, the Tao of reversing pain and aging, something about it resonates with you where you feel you must pick it up and come to see me because I can serve you. I can help you. So this is an example of how you would communicate with those souls. You would also tell them about your other forms of connection. Find my website, www.asoulhealer.com. Email me. Give them your email. My phone number is 808-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Remember, you're not talking to the individual directly, but by stating everything that is in their path, their visual real-world path, they will find it. And when they see it, they will have a natural connection to it and zero resistance. Why will they have zero resistance? Because you took the time to ask heaven to support you, to ask heaven's generals and soldiers and marketing teams to support you, to do love and to do forgiveness, and you've connected with them for a win-win scenario. Now, in your communication with them, you want to tell them how you will serve them. That's part of the win-win. How does that look? During my class, I will share with you how to open your heart, how to identify the root blockages to the pain that you are experiencing in your life. I will give you tools and techniques where you will be empowered to release those blockages and feel better quickly. I'm so honored for this opportunity to serve you. I look forward to you coming. So now I've shared with them how I can benefit them. If there's a cost, I will state that cost. The event cost is $35 for this 3-hour evening. And during this evening, I will offer several blessings that will normally have an honor fee of $150. So don't worry about the money, it's well worth it. I will tell them that. So when they see the money, their soul will tell them, ah, don't worry about the money. Their mind will say, $35, da 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 da. But their soul will say, don't worry about the money. Huh? The value of soul marketing, you can overcome objections way in advance because you're coming from the heart, because you're taking the time to connect soul to soul first. You're taking the time to release the blockages. So then when you stated everything that you wish to state, you complete it by doing service. You would ask all your transmissions, download treasures to turn on. If you have one of Master Shaw's books with the calligraphy, you would trace it. If you have Love, Peace, Harmony song, chant it. Try to give it 5 minutes. If you want success, more time is better. You have to understand that the calling forth and the talking is a big part of it. But if you do not put power behind it to set it into motion, to give heaven time to go out there and deliver your message, to stand behind your message, it's not going to work. But Master Shaw offers a blessing. He can remove the termites in the house, so to speak, but you have to spend time to rebuild the wood. He can remove the blockages along your spine, but you have to chant to rebuild the spine. If you do the soul marketing, you can remove the blockages so that people will come, but you have to spend the time to propagate and empower what you put out there. So it is important to chant for 5 to 10 minutes afterwards to fully empower those souls and really boost up the probability of you receiving what you have requested. You would repeat that process every day. So you might have to put in 15 to 20 minutes once a day. A small price to pay for a large level of success when you think about it. So it's a very powerful form of communication that's been brought to us by Dr. and Master Shaw. And for those of you that want a little bit more information, it is in the Power of Soul book. I want to say chapter 10 or 11. I looked at it yesterday, but I didn't pay attention to the chapter. But it is written in the table of contents. And he was taught soul marketing by the divine. You know, back when he was given the words to write the book. And he doesn't, you know, Master Shaw is amazing. He writes a book in 1 week. He doesn't even know half the words that come out of his mouth. They're just flowing out the divine words. And he asked the divine, how do I market this book? And he said, do soul marketing. That's how he learned this. And so we're just doing something that we already know works. And you just have to try it, right? What does he say? If you want to know if a pear is sweet, you have to taste it. Okay, so that is a crash course in soul marketing. I know I spoke it very quickly, but here's the beautiful value of a video. You can watch it again and again. So now I will do, give me a second. So today I'm going to only do flows specifically for how to apply soul marketing to your specific comment or request, okay? And so if it was specific to a business, I want to know the name of the business. I want to know exactly what that business does. If it's specific to some healing aspect that you want to grow, I want to know the name of it, what aspect of it you're trying to grow, okay? Then I will offer a flow specific to the soul marketing that would be best for that, to give you more flavor and more fulfillment so that you feel comfortable in applying it, okay? So I see RD says, beloved Master Paul, it's always an honor to attend your events and receive your wisdom. I should be grateful to receive the text of the flow for soul marketing. I'm happy to send that to you, RD. I see your email there. Thank you so much. And if you guys don't want to post your email publicly, you can send it in the form of a message, a Facebook message to me. That's okay too. And I think I had a question here earlier. I'm scrolling back to that. So Kristen says, Kristen Strachan says, dear Master Paul, if you do any readings, I would very much like to know why all these obstacles are springing up regarding my trying to get to the retreat in San Diego. I know they're going. Aha. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. What I'm hearing for you, Kristen, is actually that you need the extra money for the extra blessings that will be offered. There will be certain things offered that you'll have money for because you didn't go. So I hope that helps. Great to see you, Loveness. So I'm waiting for you to ask any question you have specific to this this area of flow. I'm just so happy my phone and my Facebook live stream is not skipping. Oh, this last 3 days is amazing testing. Okay. So Archana says, dear Master Paul, I'm looking for a job in a specific organization where I have worked for more than 18 years. Will this be possible? Okay, so how would we do soul marketing for that? To the soul of Archana, Archana's question, the soul of this organization that he is speaking of. Think of this organization, Archana. Could you please come? To the soul of soul marketing, please offer guidance for Archana at this time. How? For our dear Archana, there is jealousy, there is protectionism, there is the word is incest that I'm hearing, but what it's referring to is family members promoting family members inside. That is currently creating blockages in your ability to hurtle forward. You actually have the skill set to be about at least one third higher in the organization that you're currently at. What would be of value for you to do is to do soul marketing forgiveness to all of those souls in that, from where you're at to that next layer where there's a breakthrough point. Because there's two different levels of soul marketing I'm hearing for you. So you would ask for forgiveness to all of those souls in that first third. if in any lifetime you have passed them up for promotion, that you have uplifted your relatives first, that you have done anything along the lines of taking bribes for upliftment, or anything that you know was relatively commonplace in that culture, ask for forgiveness for any lifetime that you or your ancestors have done that and kept others pushed down, and therefore have caused blockages in their finances and their ability to move forward. Very important. At the same time, do soul marketing to the upper third, and ask them to pay attention to your who you are, your thoughts, your words, your actions. And I'm getting, I don't know what exactly you do, but the message I'm getting is that you do, you have, there's something you can create. It's like something you can show, or physically they can see something that you do that that will catch their eye. And you don't want to purposely bring it in front of them, but by doing the soul marketing and asking for forgiveness, it'll come around. You might be at a family dinner or something like that, a friend of a friend of a friend, and then that person happens to be a person in the company that's at that level that you need to rise up to, and you share with them your idea, and then they see her, and then you can get uplifted. And there won't be resistance because you've done the work before. So I don't know if that makes sense the way I've explained it, but that's what I'm hearing about how you would move up through those ranks, given some of the resistance that I'm gathering. So hopefully that assists you. How? Okay, so Suki Singh, beloved master, I humbly request to please guide me for my Sukh soul healing service. So, for soul marketing for this, for Sukh. How? For our dear Sukh. You must choose a specific area that you specialize in. Our suggestion is something related to the woman, something related to their emotions and emotional balancing, self-worth, etc. When you do a soul marketing for a specific niche in this arena, and you do physical marketing for a specific niche, word of mouth, etc., will start to gather. Those that you serve will definitely feel results, and they will grow your base. The results will come naturally if you can niche yourself. This is our suggestion. Apply everything else that has been taught in soul marketing to this niche. You will be successful. How? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so Anne-Marie, dear Master Paul, my blockage is to serve people in groups and in areas I am presently serving. This is specific to your blockages, Anne-Marie? Okay. How? For our beloved Anne-Marie. You have a need to be liked and appreciated, to not be judged, to not be criticized. You have a need to maintain your, I don't want to use the word ego, but that's the word I'm hearing. Because ego sounds harsh, but it's really about your status, how you're seen. And this creates a circular resistance. For you, my dear, what we recommend is not trying to break into a new audience, but instead serve with love and peace and harmony. If somebody has a resistance to that, it is no longer your problem. You have enough strength to where your ego would not be challenged by that. If you trust, initiate a place. It doesn't have to be an important or special place, a place to chant at, and start a small groundswell group whose purpose is to serve humanity. And that is the only purpose. Others will come. No need to teach anything, no need to talk about anything that might challenge you. If you just focus on love and peace and harmony and use the chanting, everything else will grow from there. There will be naturally questions asked, and you will naturally be able to share and explain. This will help you to overcome your fears and your lack of confidence, which are rooted in the desire to not be judged. This is our recommendations. Apply everything else and the soul marketing as suggested. How? So Yvonne asks, what am I doing? What am I going to do? I have the financial abundance workshop spot, but no money for the transportation, hotel, and food expenses. And tomorrow is Thursday already. There is not what I wished fast enough. Do you have a car? If you have a car, you can drive there, sleep in the car. There are several people that are doing that. There are people that are coming that have no food money, but they're not going to eat. Everyone is a little bit different. If you trust, you will be rewarded. If you go, somebody will give you a floor to sleep on. If it's too expensive and you can't go, then give up the donation for somebody else to take advantage of. You have to make the hard choice, Yvonne. There's no simple choice. Michelle asks, welcome Michelle. Dear Master Paul, it's lovely to have seen you over the past few days. I have two businesses, True Nutrition and Talam Wellness. I do not feel aligned. I do not feel that either are my true path. I am exhausted. I would be honored with some guidance. I do not know why I feel offerings are not well received. I also feel guilty that I cannot give enough. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. For our dear Michelle. There is several aspects that are occurring with both of these businesses that have roots in financial receiving blockages. There is guilt held and brought upon you from karma and from teachings that you have adopted in this lifetime. You have certain lacks of confidence in your ability to be seen as an authority in these areas. It feels like climbing an oil slick pole to be seen for the knowledge that you have. There does not appear to be anyone that appreciates you. The deeper roots are what need to be addressed. it would be of value for you to have a separate communication to get to some of those deeper roots. The businesses themselves, the knowledge that you carry, have potential. The markets that you have explored have not been correctly connected to. And when the roots are cleaned up and the marketing correctly aligned to both the right endpoints and through the correct soul marketing, you will start to see a return on your efforts, additional confidence in your own abilities, and the removing of the slickness of the pole. How? So you may want to check with me later on that one, Michelle. There's some additional information there that we should spend some time with. I wasn't getting any specifics, but that's what I got at this time, okay? Okay. China says, Daganan, you're very welcome. Greatest gratitude. Diraj says, Dear Master Paul, I'm trying to start business with Italy and in India for quite a long time, but not a breakthrough yet. Opportunities come, but they are going away without results. I'm going to do my best with that one, Diraj, but it does help to have specifics as far as business name and type of business. Hey, 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 yeah, what I'm hearing is your soul is stopping you. That, that if you were to be successful, you would have a chance of a financial pain. That there is unsavory aspects in Italy, and that there's like back parlor money, people that want money on the backside that you haven't even got to yet. And that your soul is just, it's just not saying, it's saying that's not the right place for you. So you might want to look at a different location. Okay. Loveness soul marketing for my TV show to start reaching its fullest potential. Okay. For our dear loveness, it is important, if people are to be reached, for you to have a message with an end result. For example, this one doing this live stream today. He has stated, on today's show, I will cover this subject. He then does what, why, how, and shares the value to all those at the end. In order for your show to gather steam, in order for your soul marketing to gather steam, in order for your visibility to gather steam, you must have an intention that can change from show to show or week to week. So put forth that intention of what you wish to accomplish, how the end result, how the viewer will receive a value at the end. It is recommended that you utilize your divine healing hands to serve those on the show, those who watch. You could make that one aspect as a reward for them to watch your show to the end by offering them a divine healing hands blessing. This is just one example of how you can better grow your visibility. General requests bring general results. Specific requests bring specific results. Be more specific, you will have more specific results. How? Thank you, Heaven, for that response, for loveness. Suki says, thank you. Anne-Marie says, thank you. Yvonne, not sure what the response was there, Yvonne, to what question. And Kristen says, thank you. I, Michelle says, thank you also. Wonderful. Well, we're just about at the end of the hour here, so thank you all so much for coming. I'm so happy I was able to share everything that I wanted to share yesterday that did not come out the way I expected. There's a lot of people that I saw their hearts fly up. John, I saw yours jump up there. Coleman, I saw Kristen sign in, Kristen Rojas. I'm sure there's others that are watching that I haven't acknowledged. I apologize. I can only acknowledge you if you show up on my Facebook feed. So I apologize if I haven't. I love you all. I'm truly grateful for this opportunity to be here and share with you. So if you've enjoyed this, please like it and share it. If you want to be advised of all of my live streams, at the end of this, when I stop the feed, I believe right above it, it says something about connecting to my live streams. Follow. I think it says follow. If you click on that, then you'll know whenever I go live. Tell others about this, how I can best serve them. Do know that I do offer a soul coaching for people's businesses. And basically what I do is I listen to what's going on with them. We do soul guidance. I get a lot of the specifics about what's worked, what has not worked, and the soul guidance very often helps kickstart. And then I work with the people for about 4 or 5 sessions, and we navigate through some of the minefields that have been there in the past. We find new avenues to go, and we start to incorporate all the aspects of the soul. I, of course, utilize some of my soul healing treasures, and additional blessings can be offered to help clear many of the blockages that are present. So that's available for anyone that is of interest. And you can message me separately in Facebook if that is. So I truly appreciate you coming. Jagmeet, I'm sorry you came in a little bit late. We're just finishing now. But I'm happy to check in with you later on this. Tomorrow, Friday. Is tomorrow Friday? Tomorrow is Thursday. I'm not sure exactly what I'll be talking about, but I'll send out a video early in the morning to let you know. I'll go by guidance. So until then, love you all. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.